All right, guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to discuss a major shift, or rather shifts, in the top 10 meta. So remember when we had Hulk as number 9 and Gore as number 10? Unfortunately, now Gore is number 12 on this list, and Hulk is number 11 on this list. With now Carnage being 10, Strife is 9, Ghost Rider is 8, Thanos is 7, 6 is Spider-Man, 5 is Jean Grey, 4 is Madelyn Pryor, which is the character I'm going to be discussing, who I don't currently have. So let me go all the way. So Madelyn Pryor is number 4. And Wolverine is number 3, with Silver Surfer being number 2. I still think very solidly that Adam Warlock is number 1 still, with Conquest and supports, while Silver Surfer is number 2, and he's very, very close. So Madelyn Pryor is number 3. Number 4. She's not better than Wolverine, because Wolverine's cooldown on his fifth skill makes him extremely relentless, and he has an advantage in Otherworld Battle because of that, whereas if Madelyn Pryor was debuffed, she wouldn't. So I'm placing her in number 4. She doesn't have a uniform. She is really packed with a lot of power and a ton of iframes. The only iframes that she doesn't have are 1 and 3. If her counter is triggered, it's an iframe. Otherwise, the second half of it is an iframe. Her 4 is a full iframe, and her 5 is a full iframe. Now, a lot of people have been asking me what's her manual rotation, and I could honestly say, without even using her and while fighting her, and while her canceling her skills a lot, because I'm sure one of these skills gives her super guard break. Commander mentioned it. I think it was either 4 or 5, but or 2, because I think with 2 as a counter, see, the second half of it is an iframe, but when it's triggered, it's a full iframe. This can be canceled, so I can still do the counter, and then I can still land on 4 while the 5 is moving. On top of that, you can even cancel a 3 right before then. So you could use all of those skills combined to kill a lot of the meta. Now, will it be Conquest support meta? Probably not, if your Madelyn Pryor is defensive. But if your Madelyn Pryor is tier 4 and she has a brilliant Conquest, she can easily be able to kill pretty much everybody minus Conquest support teams. The reason why I'd recommend Conquest for her is because she lacks the heal, but with the heal and with the extra defense, she becomes very tanky, and she has a very low cooldown on her second skill. I mean, look, her skills are packed with buffs. She has native penetration on all of her skills, which increases with offensive CTPs and increases its effectiveness. She has recovery of HP on 2 skills. She has invincibility, damage immunity, and barrier. She has accumulation, and she has all basic attack increase. So all of her skills do heavy damage, and while they can be manually avoided, she could also have an extremely quick rotation and get her tier 4 striker up very quickly, within even around 16 to 20 seconds. You have to time your manual play rotations very precisely and very quickly, because her counter has a very low cooldown and can kill you. Activating every 5 seconds, you would have to kill her in essentially one skill, and with a Conquest, it becomes more and more difficult to do that, especially with the support. Now, I think the second choice would probably be authority, because authority gives the steal. However, it still doesn't give her the heal. So while she could still be open to attack against characters like maybe Spider-Man, characters like Wolverine, characters like Jean Grey, Thanos, their power can easily get negated by Madeline's steel effect. Her only counters then would be Warlock and Silver Surfer. And maybe, like, you know, Spider-Man to a degree. Third choice would definitely be Greed. She can still be affected and killed with Reflect if she kills you in the middle of her fifth skill, which is likely. But since Greed and Conquest give Reflect Negation and Super Guard Break, they're very recommended for energy damage characters, because energy damage characters easily be reflected still, even with three full iframes. On top of that, Greed gives her massive one-shot potential power. I've had Thanos's with a support and Hulk's with a support and Conquest bite the dust to a first skill of Madeline Pryor, let alone anything else. With Greed, she could be very, very scary, but people would rather rock her defensively for the Otherworld Battle advantages, because in Otherworld Battle, mixed with many supports, if the original top three meta, Jean, Warlock, Wolverine, if they're debuffed, she has a massive advantage. That would be the top three CTPs for her and the rotation. So now I'm going to take you into most of my toughest battles with her, both current and prior, because most of my battles that were made were prior to the Silver Surfer update that recently came out. Enjoy these battles, you know, analyze them, and you'll see who I'm able to kill her with. So these matches were taken post Silver Surfer update. So I'm fighting my friend and I'm taking down his team. He had just got his prior to tier 4, and I believe she has an authority. And as you could see, you know, Spider-Man is a very good counter to her if you time him correctly. If you just use one skill to kill her and then run away again, because like I said, her counter gives her an opening every 5 seconds to kill you. So, you know, you could also kill Madeline Pryor with Sentry and Carnage if you time your skills correctly, but at that point you'd be having to make a sacrifice, you know. So, you know, Wolverine could also do it, but he could also get caught out very quickly, but, you know, he could better utilize the two to evade. You know, Strife does struggle against Madeline Pryor, but he can also get her with a counter and a fourth skill if you time it correctly, right? Then you've got Jean and Ghost Rider and Thanos, who could all kill Madeline Pryor. However, Madeline Pryor could easily kill all of them. And if she has steel to full effect with a brilliant authority, she could easily tank damage. However, like, if your builds aren't complete, and, you know, also these meta are now highly being benefited from support characters like Colossus, like even Ancient One to a degree. So you may want to pair somebody like Madeline Pryor in Timeline Battle with another meta and Colossus to get the best out of her. But if you want to use her in a triple meta, you can definitely rock a Greed on her so she could easily kill a lot of the meta. So as you could see, I'm running away from her very, very meticulously. And you see her jerking a lot. So that's her canceling a lot of her skills, because her skills have a specific range. So there's an upside and a downside. Upside is that on manual play, I can basically avoid 90% of her skills, which is good. What's bad is that she easily triggers her tier 4 striker. And if her tier 4 striker is Wolverine, you're dead. On top of that, it triggers a glitch that allows Wolverine, for example, to use his tier 3 skill right from the start of the match if you get him in an ignore iframe. So it becomes almost like a completely rigged system. It's pretty much proof that the system is rigged against anybody below the top 100 for sure. And they haven't addressed that glitch ever. But regardless, I don't want to harp over the glitch. I would rather discuss how to beat Madelyn Pryor, or like how to use her, because as you can see, you know, she could easily be avoided on manual, and I would suggest using her on manual because you can get the best out of her if you combine all of her skills. All of her skills individually with a defensive CTP, I mean, it doesn't do the greatest damage in the world, but if, for example, you try to do an ignore iframe while she's doing her fifth, she could easily just do the counter and kill pretty much anybody. So she is meta, and she's totally different to Jean Grey. Jean Grey was a very easy opponent to kill on manual. Madelyn Pryor is definitely more of a challenge because you have to anticipate what she's going to do. And with her jerking and canceling all of her skills, you never know what she's going to do. And, you know, if she has a greed, anything could kill you. Anything. Like a first skill could kill you. On top of that, she's got residual damage. On top of that, she has penetration all the time. So it's very annoying to have to deal with her, rather than Jean Grey, who seems to have been totally replaced in Timeline Battle. I don't know so much about Otherworld Battle, but for sure, Silver Surfer, Madelyn Pryor has replaced Jean Grey almost completely because they are naturally her counters. Can Jean Grey kill them both? Yes, but Jean Grey struggles mightily against them, especially when she's not on manual. So there you could see her defensive power. You know, a Gore with greed is struggling very heavy, and I had to sacrifice him very specifically as well, so I could kill this this Conquest Warlock, who's such a problem. I mean, people want to claim who's number one without analyzing Adam Warlock with Conquest fully, with at least like top 15 of the meta, because it's really the team that's the problem. It's not really the character, it's the team setup and all of their builds combined that makes the team strong as hell. And it separates, you know, challenger teams, for example, from everybody else. Those challenger teams generally know a system that allows them to win on autoplay. So, you know, you have to figure out teams that could kill all of the meta, and sometimes you may have to build characters defensively to tank damage at specific moments. And then you have to switch to other characters at the right moments. I encourage manual play highly, because auto is only for the people that have perfect accounts and perfect builds. So For everybody else,
for majority of players, I highly encourage manual play. So Madelyn Pryor is usually first.
If she's in the team, she's going to be in the team less frequently now since Silver Surfer is here. But if Silver Surfer is banned and she is not, you will most likely see her. And you'll mostly see her with Conquest builds. So, you know, Spider-Man, Thanos, Warlock. These characters could still kill Madelyn Pryor quickly for you to
run from the rest of her skills and fight the rest of the team.
And even, like, you know, somebody like Ghost Rider has some value as well. You know, there's a lot of villains now in Timeline Battle, and Ghost Rider seems to be more of the underrated, in the underrated category now. So we have a huge shift in all of the meta. So it's very important that even though you won't see as many Madelyn Pryors anymore, you should still know how to beat her and how she operates with her AI, because she's actually the more tricky one and the more unpredictable of the top five.
Therefore, the best trick to beat her is one skill and run.
And keep in mind, her counter, when it's triggered, can kill you from anywhere. It has all of the range, so you don't want to trigger the counter. You want to try and combine just like two skills and get Madelyn Pryor out of the range of your skills with your manual play. There are many characters that, you know, they still get benefit, but now there are many characters that I mentioned in my previous video that are becoming outdated. So I can expect to see a lot more PvP meta this year. So, you know, you're going to look out for that and, you know, utilize what you have now, because what you have now might be completely obsolete in 4 to 6 months time. You know, Spider-Man is still incredible and he's a counter to the top four meta still, but that could change at any moment. So anticipate and be prepared, because Timeline Battle is becoming fun, and you know, Silver Surfer is a win for free-to-play players, and in fact all players. So you never know, they may end up fixing a lot of the issues that Timeline Battle has that I've mentioned previously. The interesting thing with Madelyn Pryor is that she is very much a luxury character, and she's the most expensive luxury. With that being said, she has the potential to get a very strong uniform in the future. And, I mean, for a character with no uniform, she's already made very, very well. And she's already very, very similar to Jean Grey in terms of her skills. But her cooldown is way shorter. Her defense is way stronger. And her tier 4 striker is like 3 times faster. So she may always be better than Jean Grey for PvP. And Jean Grey may end up being converted more into solely a PvE character. You never know. But regardless, she is going to dominate Otherworld Battle as well. And she also does trigger her tier 3 skill very quickly, probably within like 30 seconds. And that is not a lot of time at all. That's very, very quick. So, like I said, the only reason why she's not better than Wolverine is because Wolverine has a primary skill, his 5th skill, on a very low cooldown. And he could still kill blasts without a support at tier 4, he could still kill majority of blasts with a greed only. So the only thing is with a greed, he's very not very tanky. So, you know, I have to use like other meta with him to complement him. Madelyn Pryor, you could make the argument she may be better than Wolverine because of her leadership, but even still, like, her being a blast makes her more susceptible to counters like Spider-Man. So the fact that Spider-Man can still be an extremely formidable counter, especially with Conquest, does not make her better than Wolverine. So now we're coming towards the last part of the video, so of course I got to incorporate my favorite style, and I hope you guys enjoy.